So if you go back to the concepts of what we have discussed in the last class, we have talked that the design tensile strength, okay, the design tensile strength is calculated based on three categories. So the first category is TDG, which is gross section yielding, and the second category is TDN, which is net section rupture, and the third category is TDB, which is block shear failure. So among all these three, whichever is the least value, that will be your the design tensile strength. So this is what we have to find out. So the design tensile strength is calculated based on gross section yielding, net section rupture, and block shear. So after calculating all these three values, whichever is the least value, that will be your design tensile strength. So remember that. So therefore, initially you try to write down the design tensile strength, the design tensile strength, which is called as TD, T suffix D, the design tensile strength is calculated based on following criteria. So based on following criteria. So what are those criteria? The criteria are three, that is TDG, TDN, and TDB. So we have to solve for these three values now. Okay. So first one is, we let's solve for the first one, which is the design, sorry, which is the gross section yielding. This is your first one. So the gross section yielding is calculated based on TDG. And if you go back to IS 800-2007, I have said that in order to find out the gross section yielding of a plate, okay, the gross section yielding of a plate, so the value of TDG or the formula of TDG equals to AG into FI by gamma m naught. So this is the formula to find out TDG value, that is gross section yielding. Here AG is gross area of plate. So here actually a plate section is given. Okay, we are not given with any kind of other sections other than plate. So the gross area of the plate will be length into thickness. So you know the length value, which is also called as width, and you also know the thickness. So therefore the gross area will be 120 times of 8. So which gives you, well, it's a 96, that is 960 mm square. And you also know that the value of Fy is 250 megapascals or 250 newtons per mm square. And also the value of gamma m naught, the value of gamma m naught is taken as 1.1. So you can refer table 5 in order to get the values of gamma m naught. However, you can remember also. So gamma m naught equals to 1.5. Now substitute all the values and therefore you end up with the value of TDG. So AG value is 960 and FI value is 250 and gamma m naught is 1.1. So therefore the value of TDG is obtained as 218.1 kilonewtons. So this is the value of gross section yielding. This is how you have to calculate. I hope you don't have any doubts up to here, I mean so far. Now the next step which we are going to calculate is, we have to calculate the net section rupture. Net section rupture. So the net section rupture is denoted with the symbol TDN. Okay. Now, I want you to open the code books. Okay. Go through the clause which I have specified. That is, if I'm not wrong, it is 6.3. Right. So go to the clause 6.3. So if you go to the clause 6.3, what does clause 6.3 says is, it consists of three different sections. So technically four, we are going to consider only three. We are going to find out which one is best suitable. So clause 6.3 says that how to calculate the net section rupture of critical section or design strength due to rupture of critical section. Now here we have three conditions. The first condition is clause 6.3.1 talks about when you have plate connections or when you are using plates for the connections. And the second case is, that is clause 6.3.2 talks about threaded rods. So this will be talked in clause 6.3.2. And this is in clause 6.3.1. And the last case is when you have the angle sections, particularly single angles. So here you have three conditions. Now, based on the question which is given, you have to find out which clause is suitable to calculate the net section rupture, right? Now, if you see the question very carefully, it is said that a plate section is being used. So when you are using plates, you have to go for the selection of clause 6.3.1. Okay. So according to clause 6.3.1 of IS 800-2007. Okay. So according to clause 6.3.1 of IS 800-2007, for plate elements, okay. So the value of TDN is TDN equals to, the formula you can see in page number 632 under clause 6.3.1, that is 0.9 into AN into FU by gamma ML. So this is the formula which is specified. Right? I guess you are able to see this code book also parallelly. So the clause 6.3.1 talks about when you have the plates which are being connected as tension members, you have to use this formula. That's the reason why we are not using the rest of the two formulas, or rest of the two clauses. Okay, here it is 6.3.3. Anyways, so here, in order to find out the value of AN, okay, so what is AN? AN is net effective area, right? AN is net effective area. So I said the formula also, you can also refer the code book of page 33, where you have the formula to find out the AN value. So to find out the formula of AN, we have the formula B minus ND naught plus summation of PSI square by 4GI into T. So this formula is used when you have a zigzag bolting. But if you observe our question, in the question, it is not a zigzag bolting. It is a chain type of bolting. You know the clear difference between the zigzag and chain bolting. Zigzag bolting will be something like this, and chain bolting will be in line. Okay. Just beneath the one bolt, you will be finding out the another bolt. So this is the top one talks about the chain bolting and the bottom one talks about the zigzag bolt. Anyways, so since we know it's a zigzag bolting, it's a chain bolting, the formula of AN will be B minus N D naught into T. So this formula is for chain type of bolting. Okay. So AN equals to, what is B? It is the width of plate. So the width of plate is 120 mm, which is given. 120 minus N. Here N is number of bolts in a critical section. N is a number of bolts in a critical section. Now, if you see the question, you have the three critical sections. So this is the critical section one, and this is the critical section two, and this is the critical section three. So in each critical section, how many number of bolts are there? There are two bolts in each critical section. Therefore, the value of N will be two. So that's how the value of N. So these concepts we have studied in the bolted connections itself, but for remembrance purpose, I'm just letting you know. So therefore, the value of N will become 2. It is because we have 2 bolts in each critical section. So 2 times of D naught. So here the diameter of bolt is 16. So you take the diameter of bolt hole as 16 plus 2, which gives you 18 mm. Times of thickness. The thickness of the plate is given as 8 mm. Okay. So therefore, 8. So you will be ending up with the value of AN as 672 mm square. So this is the value of AN. Now substitute this all values of AN in TDN formula, which gives you to 0.9. AN value is 672 into your FU value is 410 by gamma ML value is 1.25. It's a partial safety factor. So if you solve for all these values, you are going to end up with the value of TDN as 193.5 kilonewtons. Okay. So this is how you can calculate the value of next section rupture. So they are very simple. TDG formula is, we have only one formula, which is AG into FI by gamma M naught. Okay, this formula only when only one condition is there. For whatever the types of plates or the angle sections, we have only one formula, that is this one. And to find out the value of TDN, we have three cases. The first case is plates, and the second case is threaded rods, and the third case is angle sections. Since in our problem, we are using plates, so we have adopted clause 6.3.1, and then we have calculated the value of TDN. So that's how you can calculate the value of TDN. Now the last one is block shear failure. Block shear failure. Okay, so the block shear failure is represented with TDB. Right? So now you open clause 6.4. Okay, open clause 6.4. And as per clause 6.4.1, as per clause 6.4.1 of IS 800-2007, you have two formulas to find out the values of TDB. So please refer the code books. So TDB1, you can say it as TDB1 equals to AVG into FI by root 3 into gamma M naught plus 0.9 ATN into FU by gamma ML. This is one formula. And the other formula which you have for TDB calculation is, consider it as TDB2. The formula for this is 0.9 AVN into FU by root 3 into gamma ML plus ATG into FI by gamma M naught. The block shear strength, that is TDB, of connection shall be taken as smaller of TDB1 and TDB2. Right? So you have to calculate the value of TDB1, and you also have to calculate the value of TDB2. And in between this TDB1 and TDB2, whichever is the least value, that you are going to consider as TDB, that is block shear failure. Anyways, let's solve for the TDB1 and TDB2, then we'll find out which is least, and then we'll adopt the TDB value. So before finding out the values of TDB1 and TDB2, you need to know the values of AVG. Okay. You also have to know the values of ATN. Okay. And you also have to know the values of AVN and also ATN. So these are the four values which you must solve for. Now, as I said in the previous class, again, go to page number 34 of IS 800-2007. Okay, go to page number 34 of IS 800-2007. I'll just write down here. So you go to page 34 of IS 800-2007. So at the bottom, you have figure 7. So refer this figure, which is figure 7, which talks about block shear failure. And in figure 7, you have two types. One is figure 7A and figure 7B. So figure 7A talks about the plate and figure 7B talks about the angle. In our problem, we are using the plate elements. So forget about the angle section for time being. So you don't need to worry about this part. So we are using the plate sections. Now, if you check the figure very carefully, it is given in this way. It is given in this way, that is, you have bolts which are provided here. Okay, so they made it as 1, 2, 3, 4. And now in the last class, we have talked about which bolts are in tension and which bolts are in shear. So if you remember the last class concept, suppose if I am applying the tensile force from this end, suppose if I am applying the tensile force P from this end, now the planes which are in tension are 2, 3 are the planes which are in tension. Okay. And 1, 2, and 3, 4 are the planes which are in shear. Remember this thing. So the first plane, okay, the first vertical plane will be in shear and will be in tension. And the planes which are perpendicular to tension or the shear plane. So this concept will help you to find out in our problem, which are the planes that are in shear and which are the planes that are in tension. Well, now let's find out that. So now if you observe this figure, okay, the one which I'm showing here, so this figure, if you apply tensile force from this end or from any of the ends, okay, how does it behave or how does it get fractured or how does it get sheared is, it gets sheared in this way. This is how the plate gets failed or the connection gets failed. Right, if I am applying the tensile force from this side or any side, just the diagram will get reversed, that's it. Right, so you have bolt 1, bolt 2, bolt 3, bolt 4, bolt 5 and bolt 6. Right, now your concept is to find out which are the planes that are in tension and which are the planes that are in shear. So now, can somebody unmute and say what planes are in tension and what are the planes that are in shear?
3 and 4 are in tension.
3 and 4 are in tension. Okay, fine. This is one person scenario. Okay. Shear is?
1, 2, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3. Okay, this is one shear plane.
And 4, 5, 6.
4, 5, 6. So this is another shear plane.
Tension is in 1 and 6, sir.
1 and 6, okay. So somebody has said 1 and 6. Okay. So the shear planes, are they same or anything different? I mean, if you have any other answers, please let me know. Now, fine. We have got two answers from two questions. Now, let's find out which one is correct and which one is wrong. So someone has said 3, 4 is the tension plane and the other guy has said 1, 6 is in 1, 6 is the tension plane. Now, according to you, those who haven't answered so far, according to you, which one is the correct tension plane? Is it 1, 6 or is it 3, 4?
1, 6, sir.
1, 6, okay. Anyways, so it is not 3, 4 that is the tension plane. It is the 1, 6 that is the tension plane because we are applying the force from this end. That means this will be the first row of bolts which will experience the tension. Suppose if I am applying the tensile force from the other end, not from this end, then according to Prashant Narayan, this will be the first tension tensile plane. So here we are not applying the force from this end. We are applying the force from this end. So that means this is the first plane which experiences the tension. So that's how you can identify the tension plane. to 1/6. Now the shear plane, as you said, both of you, it is fine. So the shear planes are perpendicular to the tension planes. So 1, 2, 3 is one shear plane and 4, 5, 6 is the another shear plane. Fine. Now you have got to know the shear planes concept now and the tension in compression shear zones. Now let's find out AVG. What does AVG represents? Gross area in shear. Okay. So what is the gross area in shear? So here it is, the gross area in shear is this entire section shear. So the gross area in shear is taken as this width, okay, this entire width into thickness. So what is this entire width? If you go back and if you check this problem, so this is the entire gross area in shear, which is 30 + 60 + 60. So this is the entire area which is in shear zone. I guess you are able to understand. So the gross area in shear is starting from here. I'll draw with another pencil. Yeah. So the gross area in shear is from here up to here. So this is the gross area in shear. You might ask that why we are not considering this portion, because in this portion the plate, the bolts are not available and hence they are not getting failed. If you have couple of bolts here also, you will be calculating the gross area in shear from this end to up to here. So I guess you are clear with calculation finding of the gross area in shear. So the gross area in shear is said as from the starting end to the extreme bolt. So this is the gross area in shear. So the gross area in shear will be the width, okay, which is this one, into thickness, right? So I guess you are able to understand which is gross area. So therefore the gross area in shear equals to 30 + 60 + 60, which gives you 150. So I'll write clearly here, 30 + 60 + 60. This is length into thickness. So the thickness of the section plate is 8 mm. Okay. Now you have how many shear planes? Two shear planes, one at the top and the other at the bottom. So you have two shear planes. So therefore I'm multiplying with 2. So that's how you can calculate the gross area in shear, which gives you 2400 mm². So this is how you can calculate the gross area in shear. Now the next thing is the net area in tension. ATN represents the net area in tension. What is net area? Net area equals to total area minus deduction of bolt holes. Okay, total area minus deduction of bolt holes. You can write in this way also the formula, that is B minus N D naught into T. This formula will also apply to calculate the value of net area in tension. Now, what is the net area in tension? So this is the tension plane. Okay, the 1, 2 is the tension plane. Okay, I guess you are able to follow. What is the width of this tension plane? It is the pitch distance, which is 60. You can see here. So the pitch distance is 60. Okay, so 60, which is B minus how many number of bolts are there in tension zone? So technically we have two bolts. Okay, so this is one bolt and this is the another bolt. But here, if you clearly observe the tension failure, okay, the tension failure has happened to only half part of the bolt. So half on the top and half at the bottom. So the tension failure has happened to half part of the bolt. The rest of the half part of the bolts are in the safe position only. However, they are into the plates. Okay. So you have half part at the top and half part at the bottom. So that's how you will getting the 0.5. for one bolt and 0.5 for the another bolt. So that is N. Okay, which gives number of bolts in a critical section. So after getting failure, how many bolts are there in this critical section? That is one critical section, one. You have half bolt at the top and a half bolt at the bottom. That's why 0.5 plus 0.5. Into D naught value is 18, which is the diameter of bolt hole. And then you have the thickness, which is 8. Okay, so this is how you can calculate the net area in tension. So that gives you around 336 mm square. Now the next thing is net area in shear. AVN represents the net area in shear. The same formula you can apply, that is B minus ND naught into T. So what is B value? If you check down the net area in shear, the shear is happening from starting of the plate to the extreme edge of the bolt. It is not up to extreme edge also, it is up to the center of the bolt, extreme edge of the bolt. Okay, so therefore you know this length, which is 150. That gives you 30 plus 60 plus 60, which gives you 150. So B minus N. So here you please focus what I am doing. So here in shear plane, in the bottom shear plane, you have 2.5 bolts. I mean, both in top shear plane and the bottom shear plane. How? I'll tell you. So totally I have 2.5 bolts. How? Let's see. So here you have half bolt. Here you have the half bolt. I'll draw with another color, you can understand. So here you have the half bolt, the another half bolt, and the other half bolt. That means 1 plus 0.5. Yeah, 1.5 at the bottom. And again, you have half bolt at the top, half bolt at the top, and again half bolt at the top. Okay, so you have 1.5 at the top and 1.5 at the bottom. Now here, as I said earlier, you have to consider the value of N as 2.5. How? I'll tell you once again very clearly. Okay, so let's see that how it is 2.5 and why it is not 3. Okay, see, understand very carefully here. As I said, so you have half bolt at the top, half bolt at the bottom, top again, and you have another half. Similarly, half at the bottom, half at the bottom, and another half at the bottom. Now, if you clearly identify what exactly happening here is, you just consider in such a way that, so half at top and half at bottom will give you one bolt, and half at top and half at bottom will give you the second bolt, and whichever are the last bolts that are there, you don't consider them as complete half, that is 0.5 at top and 0.5 at bottom. You just make it as 0.5 only instead of making one. I guess I'm clear for all of you. So I'll repeat once again. You have half bolt which has got failed in the shear zone at the top, and you have another half at the bottom. So you have one bolt here. And here you have half bolt at the top and a half bolt which has got sheared. So therefore half plus half will give you one. Right, now at the edges of the plate you have half bolt here and a half bolt here, so it must give you one bolt. But for safety conditions, what you are going to consider as, instead of one, you are going to consider as 0.5. okay, you just assume that only one part of the bolt has got failed instead of considering a half at the top and a half at the bottom. So that is a rule. Okay, so whichever the bolt that you are seeing at the corner portion, you don't consider them as one bolt, the entire one bolt. You just consider 1 minus 0.5, which gives you, are exactly half of the extreme bolts. So that's how you can find out the 2.5. So B minus N, which is 2.5, into D naught will give you 18, and the thickness is 8. So if you solve for this value, you will be ending up with the value of AVN as 1680 mm square. Now how this 1680 is, suppose whatever I am doing here, I am doing it for the only for one plane. Okay, you have two shear planes. One is at the top and the other is at bottom. So you have to multiply with 2. Understand? You have to multiply with 2. Now the last one is net area in tension, which is ATN. Net area in tension. Sorry, it's not ATN. ATG. You can make it as ATG. That is gross area in tension. Gross area in tension, ATG. So what is gross area in tension? 60, okay, which is the width, into, okay, 60 into thickness, which is 8, which will give you the gross area in tension, which gives you 480 mm². So you have AVG value as 2400 mm², and you have ATN value as 336 mm², and you have AVN value as 1680 mm², and you have ATG value as 480 mm². Now substitute all the values in TDB1 and TDB2, you will be ending up with the TDB1 value as 411.6 kilonewtons. And TDB2 as 384 kilonewtons. And therefore, TDB equals to least of TDB1 and TDB2. So that gives you TDB value as 384 kilonewtons. So therefore, design tensile strength of plate, that is TD, equals to, it is the least of TDG, TDN and TDB. So look for which is the least value. It is, you have 384 as 1 and 193 and 218. So among all these three, the least value is 193.5 kilonewtons. Okay, that's how you can calculate the design tensile strength.
Sir, in AVN N2.5, can you please explain, sir?
Yes, fine. I'll collect another person's doubts also. I'll clarify all the doubts at once. Yeah, anybody with any other doubts apart from AVN calculation?
AVG also, sir. Once again, yes.
Okay, AVG. Okay, fine. That is also fine. Anything else? Fine. I'll start with all the four values, however. So the first thing is, I'm going to calculate the value of AVG. Okay, I'll draw the diagram once again for your reference, and then we'll look at the concept. So the failure will occur in this way. This is how the failure connection looks like. Okay, now as we were discussing earlier, first we need to identify which are the shear planes and which are the tension planes. So if you consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, you can give numbering in as your wish. So the tension plane is the plane, okay, always remember the tension plane is the plane, whichever the side that you are applying the load, the first bolts are the bolts which experience the tension. That means the bolts 1 and 6 will experience the tension. Make sure the bolts, the whichever the bolts that are experiencing the tensile force, okay, or in, you can remember in this way, if you are applying force from this side, okay, if you are applying force from this side, the first bolts which experience the tension are 1 and 6. So right, you are clear, you must be clear with this. The first bolts which experience the tension are whichever the bolts that are there near to the tensile load or near to the application of the tensile. Now the shear planes are the planes which are perpendicular to the tension plane. That is 1, 2, 3 is one shear plane and 4, 5, 6 is the another shear plane. That means you have two shear planes and one tension plane. Now we have to find out the values of AVG. let's look at AVG. AVG represents gross area in shear. Okay, so gross area in shear. What do you mean by gross area? It is the total area in shear. So what is the total area in shear? You know that. So this part, this entire part of the plate has got failure. That means you will be having another part of this which has got detached from here. That this part has completely detached. So that means this entire portion has experienced the shear failure. This entire portion has experienced the shear failure. The orange color line is experiencing the shear failure. Now this entire area, since it's a rectangular, the value of area will be length into width or length into thickness. Anything is fine. Okay. So what is the length here? The edge distance you have 30 mm and the pitch distance you have the 60 mm and another pitch distance you have 60 mm. Okay. So therefore the length will be 30 plus 60 plus 60. So this is the length in shear into thickness. So the thickness value is 8. So that's how you can calculate the net area in tension, gross area in shear, length into thickness. So that this is the total portion which is experiencing the shear failure. So that's why I have calculated the total length. Since how many planes we are having? We are having two planes, two shear planes, one at the bottom and another one at the top. So therefore I'm multiplying with 2. So gross area in shear must be clear. Now let's look at the another value, which is gross area in tension. Let's find out the gross areas initially. So gross area is the total area. So which are the tension zones? So this is the tension plane. This portion, I'll draw with another one. Just hold on. Yeah. So this is the tension plane. You can make this as the tension plane. The first tension plane. What is this distance? This distance is 60. That is the center to center distance between poles. It is given here. So you can see. So this distance is 60. So the same distance I have kept here. Fine. The distance is 60. So therefore the gross area in tension equals to 60, which is the length, into thickness. So we are having how many tension planes? We are having only one tension plane. We don't consider the tension plane of 3-4 because we are going to consider the tension failure only for the bolts which are near to the tensile force. Okay. So therefore you are going to get the gross area in tension. Now let's find out the another value, which is gross area in shear. Net area in shear. AVN. What is net area in shear? You know the formula, which is total area minus deduction of bolt holes. Total area minus deduction of bolt holes. Instead of using this formula, you can also use this one, which is B minus N D naught into T. Anything is fine. So B minus N D naught into T. So let's look at what is B, what is N and all. So you know the value of B is 30 plus 60 plus 60, right? 30 plus 60 plus 60. Same as we calculated here. So the value of B is 30 plus 60 plus 60. So this is the width or length, you can say, minus N. N is number of bolts in a critical section, right? So how will you calculate N here is, very carefully you observe. So this is one bolt, half of the bolt, which has got failed. So initially they will be like this, before the application of the load. So after, when you apply load, when you apply the tensile force, how does it get failures? Only half bolt will get failed. Half bolt, half, 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 and half. Okay, so this is how it gets filled. So half plus half, half bolt at the top and a half bolt at the bottom will give you one bolt. And half bolt at the top and a half bolt at the bottom will give you second bolt, or you can say another one bolt. And when you come to the extreme edge, what you are going to consider is, instead of considering as a half at top and a half at bottom, you just consider them as half bolt only into T, where T is the thickness. Now, how many shear planes you are having? You are having two shear planes. So therefore, I am multiplying with two, one at the top and the other. This is how you can calculate the net area in shear. So the total length, which is B minus N into T into number of shear planes. You have two shear planes. Okay, the total length, you know, 30 plus 60 plus 60, which is 30 plus 60 plus 60, one top and bottom both. And here you just have to worry about how many number of bolts, that is N value only. Suppose you have three bolts here. So initially you have three bolts, right? Three at top and three at bottom. So let's forget about this entire concept of 1 plus 1 plus 0.5. So find out in each row how many number of bolts are there. Suppose, say for example, you would have 5 bolts. Okay. So when you are calculating AVN value, okay, when you are calculating AVN value, you just assume it this way. The total bolts in one row, that is 5 bolts, only for one row I'm calculating, the total bolts in one row minus 0.5. It gives you 4.5. And so here also you can see, I'll let you know how it is 4.5. See, you can see this. So half at the top, right? 0.5 at the top and 0.5 at the bottom. And again, 0.5 at the top, 0.5 at the bottom, you will get one bolt. Again, 0.5, 0.5, which will get another bolt. And again, 0.5 and 0.5, which you get one bolt. Okay. So here it is also 0.5 and 0.5. But here, you, instead of considering as one, you are just taking it as 0.5. So therefore, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 0.5, which gives you 4.5. Or you can also consider in this way, the total bolts in each row minus 0.5 will give you the value of N when you are solving for AVN. Are we clear? You can remember any one of the concepts. Are we clear? Any doubts so far? And now let's look at for the ATN, that is net area in tension. So again, the same formula, which is B minus ND naught into T. Okay, B minus ND naught into T. The value of B in tension zone is, it is 60. Okay, 60 minus N is half at the top and half at the bottom, which gives you 0.5 plus 0.5, which is N into D naught is 18 into T is 8. So you have only one tension plane. However, you will get. Fine then. You can keep this problem as your homework or as your assignment. Okay. So you can keep this problem as your assignment. Try to solve the problem and understand how you're solving, whether you're getting or not. Thank you. Thanks for joining.